So myself, H.S. Nagaraju, selection grade lecturer, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Government CPC Polytechnic, Mysore. So today, in this session, I am going to explain some basic concepts of MATLAB. In session 1 and session 2, you already learned some concepts about MATLAB. Here in session 3, I am going to explain some more concepts like getting started with MATLAB, how to create the variables and how to delete, how to correct the error messages like this. Session 3, MATLAB, how to use a MATLAB as a calculator. The most basic use of MATLAB is to use it as a fancy MATLAB calculator. This simply means we can execute mathematical operations in the command window, much like you can do with a calculator. And the main application of the MATLABs, it's a high-level language, as we all know that it's a high-level language and interactive. It provides an interactive environment for numerical computation, visualization and programming. So by using a MATLAB, we can analyze the data, develop an algorithms and create models and the applications. In addition to this, you can also use this MATLAB as simple as your handheld calculator. So when you open the MATLAB, so this window will be displayed, appeared. In window, this is our command window of MATLAB. In command window, the command prompt appears. In front of the command prompt, we are going to type our expression, mathematical equations. And here are some examples. It can be used as a calculator. Mathematical computation can be done as we do in calculator. So here, this is a MATLAB command prompt. In front of this prompt, we can type here. So there is a equation 10 plus 11 minus 12, answer will be equal to 9. So after this, if you press enter, you will get answer equals 9. ANS is a short form of an answer. It is a default variable which is used by the MATLAB. If the user has not specified any variable, the MATLAB will obtain the result and assign the output to the default variable ANS. Another example, 6 into 7 minus 3, and the answer for this is 39, 4 to the power of 2. Answer for this is 16. Creating a variables. What are the variables? Variables are the memory locations where we are going to store some values. Input and output values are stored in the name of variables in specific memory location. Those memory locations are named as variables. And here, there is a provision to define the variable by the user. If user is not defined any variable, the software itself create the variable, a default variable ANS. The MATLAB workspace, which consisting of the variables, you can create and store in memory during a MATLAB session. You can also create new variables in the workspace by running MATLAB code or using the existing variables. To create a new variable, enter the variable name in the command window followed by an equal sign and the value you want to assign to the variables. So as in the case of another programming languages, here also we have to create the variables to store the values. But here, where we no need to declare the variable before starting of the program. At any stage of the program, we can create our variables and we can initialize the variable. at any point. And how to name the variables. So naming of variables, variable names consisting of a letters, digits and an underscore. So other than this, we cannot use any other symbols or even space is not allowed for naming the variables. And also MATLAB is a case sensitive. Case sensitive means here in MATLAB, uppercase letters are different from lowercase letters. So if uppercase letters are used to declare the variable, so in all the time you need to use the uppercase letters only. So capital A is different from a lowercase e. Variable names can be of any length. So any length, but however, MATLAB uses only first n characters where n is given by the function. Name length max, by using this we can change the characters of the variable. MATLAB variables. In MATLAB environment, every variable is an array or a matrix. You can assign variables in a simple way. For example, here x is a user defined variable. So you can name the variable as x, and this x is initialized with a value 3. The value 3 is assigned to x. Here we are defining x and initializing the x with a value 3. This command creates one by one matrix named x and stores the value 3 in its element. Other way, x can be equal to square root of x, sqrt square root of 16, sqrt 16, defining x and initializing it. This value is x. Here we have overwritten the value, the variable x. Earlier the value was 3, now the value of x is 4. The value is varied from 3 to 4. The current value of x is 4. Once a variable is entered, you can refer it later. Variables must have values before they are used. When an expression returns a result that is not assigned to any variable, the system assigns it to a variable named ANS. ANS is a default variable. It is a short form of answer, which is used by the MATLAB. If the user has not specified any variable for an expression, so the result will be stored in a default variable ANS. So another example, the square root. If here the user has not specified any variable, so here the expression is here. MATLAB will execute the above statement and return the following result. ANS equals 8.83. So this is the equivalent value for result of square root of 78. Here the ANS value is 8.8318. So we can use this value. We can use this result to compute further. So that is here 9876 divided by ANS. Here the ANS is a default variable whose value is equal to 8.8. So the result for this expression will be ANS equals 1118.2. Okay, let's look at another example. X equals 7 into 8. Here the star symbol is used for multiplication of two numbers. X equals 7 into 8 and Y equals X into 7.8. Here we use semicolon to terminate this statement. Here it will not display an immediate result. But in this expression, we have not used a semicolon. This expression is not terminated by semicolon. So you will get the result as y is equal to 441.84. So if you execute this expression, you will get this result. Here 7.89 is multiplied with x value. X value is 7 multiplied by 8. 56 into 7.89. The answer will be y is equal to 441.84. So how to assign the multiple statements in a single line? So we can have multiple assignments on the single line by using semicolons and commas. Here, each statement is separated by a semicolon, and all three statements, three commands are typed in a single line. A equals to semicolon, B equals 7 semicolon. Here we will not get an immediate results, because after each statement, after each expression, so we have put semicolon. So semicolon will not produce a immediate result. B equals 7 semicolon and C equals A into B. Here there is no semicolon, so the MATLAB will display the answer. So here we have used C variable. C is equal to 14. MATLAB will execute the above statement and return the following result, C equals 14. Suppose the user have forgotten the variables. So whatever the variables created by user, he may have forgotten at later stage. So he can retrieve the number of variables created by the user. The command who command helps to display all the variables names, variable names we have used, the user have used in the program. Who command, so if you type the who, WHO who, in front of command window prompt, the MATLAB will execute the above statement and return the following result. So that it will display the answer is your variables are A, ANS, B and C. So in previous example we have used A, B and C. In addition to these user defined variables, the MATLAB will also display the default variable ANS. And all the variables are displayed in alphabetical manner. A, ANS, B, C. And another command, in who command, that will display only the names of the variables. But another command, whose command, WHOS, whose command, which displays the little more details about the variables. So which displays variables currently in the memory, type of each variables, data type of the each variables, and memory allocated to each variable, and whether they are complex variables or not. All the details will be displayed if you type the whose command in front of the command prompt. Another command to clear the variables created by the user, we can use the clear command. The clear command which deletes all the variables or specified variables. If you specify particularly the variable name along with the clear command, it will clear the particular variable. Suppose if it is not specified any variable, if you type just clear, it will clear or delete all the variables in the workspace. Example, clear X. So it will delete only variable X. Suppose if you just type clear, it will delete all the variables in the workspace. So there are some special variables and constants used in the MATLAB. So MATLAB supports the following special variables and the constants. Here are the list. ANS, it is a most recent answer. It is a default variable supported by the MATLAB. EPS, accuracy of floating point precision. IJ, imaginary unit, infinity, and not a number, undefined numerical result. Pi. Pi is also another variable. Pi, the number pi whose value is equal to 3.14. how to overwrite the variable. So the variable, as the name itself indicates, the value is changing. If you assign another value to the same variable, so the new value will be updated to the variable. It is nothing but overwriting the variable. Once a variable has been created, it can be reassigned. If you do not wish to see the intermediate results, you can suppress the numerical output by putting a semicolon at the end of the statement. Then the sequence of commands looks like this: t equals 5, t equals 5 plus 1. Here t equals 5 for the first statement, there is this statement is terminated by a semicolon, so this will not display any result, immediate result. The next statement, so t equals 5 plus 1, here this expression is not terminated by semicolon, so it will display the immediate result, t is equal to 5 plus 1, then t equals 6. Here the value is changed to 6. Earlier the value is 5 was 5, now the value of t is equal to 6. The value 6 is stored in the variable t. Error message. So if you type any expression incorrect, the MATLAB will return an error message. For example, so let us look into this expression, x equals 10, and it is terminated by semicolon, and next statement is 5x. The MATLAB will not understand this 5x. There must be an operator between 5 and the x. That operator is missing. That will be displayed like this. This is an error. That error is displayed like this. So with question mark of 5x, error message, missing operator, comma or semicolon. If anything wrong in the expression, the MATLAB will display an error message. But to make the corrections, we can retype the expression. How to retype the expression? You can directly retype the expression. Suppose if the expression is long, so we can recall the previous command by pressing the up arrow. By pressing up arrow, so we can retrieve or recall the previous command. And if the previous command is displayed, appears on the prompt, it can be modified and be executed. So like this, we can correct the expression and we can remove the error message. So this is about some basic concepts about variables which are used in the MATLAB. Thank you.